can have her go out and take a look at it before the village board considers it as well.
Let me ask you this, Katie. We're not being asked for a variance for anything with the stormwater, right? I mean, he could put up the fence regardless if it was within the height.
Yeah, correct. Sometimes we will work with people to lift them off the ground slightly if there are drainage issues in the area. Marilyn, our stormwater administrator, is very, very cautious and very particular about these types of things.
Okay.
In looking at that property, any kind of fence put up is going to significantly affect visibility and everything all throughout the block. Just a comment.
Yeah, and there's several in the neighborhood. If you walk that, I walk the neighborhood all the time. There, it's not prevalent, but there's several of them. Yeah. And then the lots vary. There's some, the lots on this part are, the houses are pushed in a way where the backyards are pretty narrow.
And sorry to interrupt. We are requesting only in the backyard, not on the side yet. Side is okay, you know. Back is the slope, you know, we have it. So no. In the back, we are requesting 8, and the side is regular, you know, 6. You know, so.
The side's going to remain 6 feet. If I may ask the neighbor who spoke, what is the distance to that swale from your back window?
I'd say from our back door, I'd say maybe 10 feet.
Would you take the microphone?
I'm sorry. You know, I can only guess, but my best guesstimate is probably 10, 12 feet out my back door.
Thank you.
So it's pretty close.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, I don't know what kind of ground we're standing on here, but this is the first fence in the area. I'm looking at the aerial view, and I certainly wouldn't approve 8 foot. I would like the gentleman to at least do a 6 foot picket fence if he needs to keep his dog in or the dogs out, but 8 foot, absolutely not.
Yeah.
What?
Picket fence?
There's another right? fence.
Yeah, we just, the one that would like the one we just
I
approved.
I can't see any in the,
yeah, look at the pictures.
Aerial view here.
Look at the other pictures. That's the one we just approved.
Yeah, I know, but I can't see any in this aerial view I'm looking at.
Yeah, you know what, though? The privacy fence issue, we don't get a say in that. We only get a say in
It's in our...
I understand, right. As I said, but to have the first fence in this area be 8 foot, to me, would be objectionable.
Okay. And that's the issue before our commission right now is are we going to allow a 2 foot variance for the back lot line? Right. I mean, we could close the public hearing.
Variance is 8 feet as opposed to 6 feet. Yes.
Right. So I guess we could probably close the public hearing. We can have discussion during regular meeting on this.
I move we close the public hearing.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Anyone opposed? Public hearing is closed. Okay. I assume we should take this up right now. I understand what you're saying. I think you set a precedent by going 8 feet. I understand the petitioner's request because of the drop off. I get that piece, but if you set a precedent with this one, then you could have them the whole way down. It probably would not be the right thing.
Next one will be 10.
For the way this neighborhood's platted and the way the houses were developed in this neighborhood, it wouldn't be the right thing.
If nobody complained, that's different. But
well, I think there were some very good points brought up. It's a balancing act for us. So.
Are you ready for a motion?
I'm looking to the rest of you. If people want to ask Katie other questions or petitioner other questions, if no one has any other questions, I think we could probably, we have the facts before, so I think we take a vote on this.
On the facts, yeah.
I move we reject the approval of a zoning variation pursuant to section 5-1-B3 of the zoning regulations to permit an 8-foot final privacy fence in the rear yard at 565 Spruce Lane.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion or questions? Hearing none, Katie, can you please call the roll?
Yeah, so just to clarify, an aye rejects the variance. Because
yes.
Commissioner, just want to clarify that. Commissioner Thorne?
Aye.
Commissioner LaFon?
Aye.
Commissioner Pat?
Aye.
Commissioner Murphy?
Aye.
Commissioner Sima?
Aye.
Chairman Rigo?
Aye.
Motion fails.
So, Katie, can you please explain to the petitioner what this means? Because it could still go to the board, but it has to be overruled by supermajority then?
Yeah, so the village board makes the final decision, so the plan commission's recommendation this evening is negative, so I will contact you tomorrow with their next steps.
Okay.
Thank you very much, and thank you people for coming out.
Thank you.
Our last item tonight in the public hearing arena is the Wellness Center Special Use Permit. Petitioner Richie 5800 Forest View Road. Is the petitioner available?
No.
Good evening. Planning and Health, can you please read the notice?
Notice is hereby given that a public hearing of the Village of Lisle Planning and Zoning Commission will be conducted on August 18, 2015 at 7 p.m. in the Lisle Village Hall, 925 Burlington Avenue, Lisle, Illinois, 60532, to consider the following request. Approval of a special use permit pursuant to Section 5-9-2B, B2 Special Uses of the Zoning Regulations to allow for the operation of a fitness center. The subject property is commonly known as 5800 Forest View Road. The subject property is legally described upon Exhibit A attached to the notice. The following documents comprised part of the application are open to inspection until August 19, 2015, between the hours of 8:30 a.m. and 4:30 p.m. at the office of the Village Clerk at 925 Burlington Avenue, Lisle, Illinois, after which the documents will be available pursuant to the Village Freedom of Information Act procedures. Application, plat of survey, floor plan, easement agreement, public hearing notice, list of surrounding property owners. The owner is Four Lakes Investment, 4 North 215 Doral Drive, West Chicago, Illinois, 60185. The petitioner is Richard Ritchie, 6020 Oakwood Drive, Lisle, Illinois, 60532.
Good evening, sir. Can you please raise your hand? The testimony you're about to give is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Thank you. State your name for the record, and then you can proceed with your presentation.
Richard Ritchie. There is an open unit in the middle of Four Lakes. It was formerly used as a dance hall and for banquets. It's a beautiful space. It's over 4,000 square feet. Aesthetically, it's very nice to look at now. The objective is to open a wellness center that is elegant and open to all ages and as much focus on the aesthetics as the functional equipment when we do, if approved. We're hopeful that that it will be good for the community. The community is health conscious. There's a ski hill there, there's volleyball courts, there's tennis ball courts, there's parks, they got frisbee, everything, boating, fishing, everything you can think of. So the idea is that the wellness center, although it will be another asset to the village itself and to the Four Lakes community. It would not be isolated for membership to only Four Lakes community, but that's it in a nutshell.
Katie, the staff is favorable to this special use in this place?
Yeah, staff supports the requested petition before you.
Great. Is there anybody in the audience that wishes to speak either? Come on down. Is this the only person that wants to speak on this one? Okay, thank you. Oh, thank you. And we have a letter from you, correct?
No.
Okay. Testimony you're about to give us the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth.
I do.
Can you state your name for the record, please?
Wanda Mariscal. I am the board of the property manager for the Four Lakes Master Homeowners Association. And I just want to state, we're not here to object to the wellness center at all. That's fine and good. The only thing we wanted you to be aware of and make sure that it's not a condition of the wellness center is in the letter, page 44 of your packet, item number 9 and 10, where he states that he will be doing things in conjunction with the Four Lakes Association.
Okay.
And also on your page 42, where it talks about special events, that none of these special events or have been discussed with the board of directors, which would have to approve them.
Okay.
So we just wanted to make that known, that if that is a condition of this, that Four Lakes Recreation or the Master Homeowners Association has no part of this at this time.
Okay.
okay?
Yeah, that's great. Thank you for the clarification.
Mr. Chairman, I didn't, ma'am.
Yes.
What was your last point about the special events?
When he has special events, we did not want that to be included in you guys saying that, okay, we're approving this because you're going to do this in conjunction with Four Lakes Recreation, okay, when in fact it has not been approved and gone before the Board of Directors at all.
He could.
If he holds a special event, or this, do they have to get the approval from?
If it's outside of his building, yes, he would. It would have to be to us in writing for me to present to my board to approve.
Are there any other restrictions for activities in this man's potential area that require approval or?
Anything that he does outside of his actual building or his front parking lot would have to be approved by the Four Lakes Master Homeowners Association Board.
Sir, were you aware of that? Is that going to be a problem?
No, it's not a problem at all.
Okay, thank you.
Ma'am, just to clarify.
Yes.
You're not objecting to the fitness center itself, right?
No.
Okay, thank you.
It's just a point of clarification for us. Like if he hosted a race, they'd have to approve it first.
I got it. I know. Yeah.
Thank you. Meg?
Yeah, quick question for you. And frankly, I'm surprised. There's not a fitness center in Four Lakes at all already?
There is in the towers, okay. Which is...
Is that only for...
I actually don't know if that's considered Four Lakes or not.
And is that only for tower residents?
Those two large buildings, there's a small little fitness area, but it's small. And
well, seems like the time is right.
Yeah,
then for,
yeah. No doubt. Is there anyone else in the audience on this request? Are there questions from members of the Planning Commission?
How long has that property been vacant?
It's been vacant. I'd have to, my friend Kirit, who's the owner of the building, it would have to answer that question.
Sir, since we're in a public hearing, I need to, can you state your name for the record?
My first name is Kirit and last name is Moradia.
Okay.
Can you guys hear me okay?
Yes, that's fine. Yeah. Testimony you're about to give tonight's the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth.
Yes.
Thank you. Go ahead.
Excuse me, but the secretary did not get this.
I'll give you
Thank you.
The property hasn't been vacant truly because we were using it as a meeting room. We were having some, you know, meetings down there. But this year, at the start of the year, we decided that, you know what, it's not worth for us to do that. I always wanted to do something different. Gym was one of the things that I was thinking for a long time. So I was thinking about doing it. Rich came in, we started talking, and that's when the whole prospect began.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
No problem.
I personally think it's a great use and fits into the comprehensive land use plan. I think we have an experienced operator. There's plenty of parking. I think it's very positive.
Thank you, sir.
Absolutely agree.
Yeah. We could probably close this public hearing then, unless there's more questions for staff or petitioner.
I don't know.
I think we've gotten plenty and we've got comments from Master Homeowners Association, which were good. So if someone wants to make a motion to close the hearing, we can move this to the regular meeting.
Mr. Chairman, I move we close the public hearing.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Anyone opposed? Public hearing is closed on this matter. I say we should take this right up now since we have the facts. It's a pretty straightforward request. It's a special use, but it's a permitted use in the area. So, and I agree with you, Commissioner Fine. I think this fits perfectly. It's a great use for this space and for this neighborhood.
Fantastic. You got an experienced operator.
And someone who, you live in there, don't you? Correct? Yeah, so we've got an owner-operator that actually lives in the neighborhood.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not much more you...
I think Commissioner Pat wants to make a recommendation.
Yeah, the recommended approval of special use permit pursuant to Section 59-2B, B2 special uses of the zoning regulations to allow for the operation of a fitness center at 5800 Forest View Road.
Second.
A motion and second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Anyone opposed? Hearing none, the motion carries. Sir, Katie will be able to tell you kind of how this will flow through for the next village board meetings. It still needs to go before the village board.
Okay. Thank you so much.
And best of luck with your project.
And Katie was so helpful through everything, so thank you very much.
Great. At this time, is there anybody, and there's a lot of people here tonight, is there anybody that wanted to come down and address the Planning Commission on any other topics? This is your chance to do so. Is there any other business, Katie, or updates for us?
No other business this evening. You will have at least one agenda item next month.
Excellent.
When is the next Board of Trustees meeting, Katie? You know?
September 14th.
September 14th.
So we have the holiday, late Labor Day this year. Great. At this point in time, if there's nothing else and no other updates, I would entertain a motion to close the meeting.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Our meeting for this evening is closed. Thank you all for coming out, and have a safe and great weekend.